Hi all, I suppose you must have gone through a holiday shopping frenzy before. While holiday can be a windfall for e-commerce businesses, the competition is stiff, stocking the right products and offering the right kinds of promotions and discounts are all key to staying on top of your game. So in this video, we'll show you how you can keep a close eye on your competitors' pricing strategies using a no-code web scraper, Octoparse. Three steps to scrap data from Amazon. Taking Christmas mugs as an example, we'd use Octoparse to collect data for this particular product on Amazon. Here is the URL of the target page. Step 1. Create a new task. Enter the target URL into the search bar, then click the Start button. The page will be loaded in the Octoparse built-in browser. Step 2. Select the data we need from the listing page. After the page has finished loading, click the Auto-Detect Website Data button on the Tips panel. Octoparse will scan the page for data that's available for extraction. You can click Switch Auto-Detect Results on Action Tips and select the set of data you need. For this example, you can choose the one that has the product title, price, rating, and the number of reviews. Notice any detected data will be highlighted in red and show in the data preview section below. In addition to the detected data, Octoparse has also detected a next page button on the target page and asks if you would like to paginate and scrap more pages. Go ahead and leave the option checked as we want to scrap all the pages. Then, click Create Workflow. You can delete the data columns that are not needed or rename the columns. For more details about scrapping the data in product or detail pages, check out the article in description box. Step 3. Scrap and export data. You can click through the steps of the workflow to check if the setup works correctly. Upon verifying all the task settings, click Run to start the scrapping process. Octoparse will take care of the rest for you. Once the run is finished, you can export the data as an Excel, CSV, or a JSON file. Quick tip, in light of the product's fast changing prices, consider repeating the scrapping regularly to keep the data up to date. You can either rerun the saved task or schedule the task to run automatically. Now that you've got the data, it's time to dive deep. There are a couple of things you can try. Track product variance pricing. Product's price can be affected by anything, such as the materials it's made of, the brand, the size, etc. With the scrapped data, you can easily carry out an analysis based on the particular set of factors. For example, by comparing the prices of mugs that share the same size but are different brands, you can find out which brand has the highest price and the lowest. You can also scrap other data like the colors or the materials to see if it has a significant effect on how the product is priced. The more details you involve into the analysis, the more you know, and all this can better help you price your products correctly and boost sales. Track prices over time to make the most of the holiday season. Retailers often use dynamic pricing strategies. Scrapping the prices regularly and comparing them against the historical prices can help you learn about how the prices are trending so you can adjust your prices ahead of time. There are, of course, many other things you can do with the prices data. For example, besides looking at the prices of individual goods, you can track the prices of all the products for a brand and see how the prices are trending for different brands. It's probably smart to stock more of those that are trending up as they are likely to be the ones that are more liked and demanded. Alright, that's it for today's video. Check out our website at octoparse.com. There are tons of amazing resources and tutorials for you to learn about web scrapping. Please give a thumb up if you like this video and subscribe to our YouTube channel for more content. Thanks for watching and see you soon!